Hi, I'm Bob. I'm with M.O.R.E. Realty. We are in the property that's going to municipal tax auction in basically 30 hours. We have a property here that's it looks like a double wide on a basement in the country. So this local county has had probably 3 years where the taxes haven't been paid. And in this particular county, they have what's called a judicial tax foreclosure. So the county has foreclosed on the property because the taxes weren't paid. The people had not objected, and the county owns this property, and they're going to auction it in 24 hours, 30 hours tomorrow night. So I came out to look at it today, and I see value.
Let me ask you, what are the upsides that you see, and what are the downsides that you see as an investor?
Well, here's a very unique thing. I've mentioned this before in some previous interviews, that mobile homes or double wides to me have value because no matter where you are, you've got, first of all, you're in the country and you're in a nice county. So it's a nice country setting. You're literally 5 minutes from a local town. That's a nice thing. Close yet far. Number two, you're in the country. You look around in the front fall, you see a beautiful tree here. So this is a nice piece of property, although it's not groomed today. In one day, you could landscape and mow this property. It's probably got 2 acres, you've got some trees next door, so it looks like a very pleasant setting. Most people would want to live in the country. When you have a home, a basement is going to cost you probably $30,000 to $35,000. To move a double-wide mobile home in here is going to cost at least $10,000 to $15,000. To buy a double-wide mobile home, even used, you're going to spend $20,000 to $30,000. So bare minimum, the land's going to be $10,000 or $15,000, the basement is $30,000. So that's $45,000, $55,000, $67,000. You couldn't replace this property for $60,000, $70,000, $80,000. So if you can buy it at auction for less than $40,000 or $50,000 or $60,000, in this market right now, I don't think you can go wrong. So I see inherent value, and the real key with these M.O.R.E. properties is if you're willing to do a little work, willing to get a dumpster, willing to reinforce the foundation, presume that the plumbing and the electric and gas lines need to be upgraded, but the structure and the bones are here. That's the value. That's also the opportunity.
As an investor, can you talk about possible exit strategies for a property like this? So if you were to buy this tomorrow night at the auction,
yes,
what are the exit strategies you have in front of you?
It's first of all very important to find out what the market is. There's two kinds of markets. A, you've got the cash market. First of all, it's a double wide. A lot of people won't even live in this. They'll say, I'm going to have to live in a trailer. That's their perception. But there's a lot of people who'd say, I don't care. Country folks would say, this is wonderful. And so the exit strategy, know what the property is worth. Fixed up, this property could be worth $100,000 or $150,000 potentially, maybe $125,000. So the exit strategies I would take would be one of two things. A, know you're going to put in $5,000 to $7,000 to fix it up and make it livable and habitable. Realistically, you could turn it on and put a for sale sign on it and sell it. You could put a for sale by owner sign on it. You could also do this. You could say, I'll sell it, owner finance. You could turn around and be the bank long term and say, all right, give me $5,000 or $10,000 down, and you hold the paper, and you sell it for $150,000 and accept mortgage payments and tell them to cash out in 3 years. So there's a lot of different ways, but this is definitely something people would want to live in, and definitely something you could sell. It's just a matter of putting it to market and advertising it. So I'd go to market with a realtor, cash, or B, hold paper, knowing you're going to have to put a couple bucks into it, but there's going to be some equity here, period.